For David Ranta, it was a moment more than two decades in the making. In handcuffs, he again faced a judge. But this time, the conviction for a murder he insists he didn't commit was thrown out.
Mr. Ranta, to say that I'm sorry for what you have endured would be an understatement and grossly inadequate, but I say it to you anyway.
Ranta mouthed thank you to the judge. Overcome with emotion, his family cheered, some cried. His handcuffs were taken off, and the judge made it official.
The defendant's motion to vacate the judgment of conviction is granted.
The judge wiped away tears as Ranta embraced his family that included a daughter who was a baby when he was convicted. With a bag of his belongings slung over his shoulder, he walked out and faced cameras.
I'm overwhelmed. It's interesting, and I would just like to say thank each and every one of you for supporting me today on this. As I said from the beginning, I had nothing to do with this case. If you're interested, there'll be as much paperwork as you'd like to read on this case.
Do you have any one thing you want to do?
Yeah. Get the hell out of here, maybe.
Ranta had always maintained he did not kill Rabbi Haskell Wurzburger, a prominent rabbi in Brooklyn's Hasidic community who was the victim of a botched robbery in February of 1990. A diamond courier was the original target. He managed to get away, and the robber shot Wurzburger and took off with his car. Ranta was arrested 6 months later, and his court-appointed lawyer says the conviction has haunted him.
The day that David was convicted, I made a promise to him that I would never forget, that I would do whatever I could in my power to set aside this verdict, to fight this injustice.
Michael Baum tried to get the conviction overturned, but a phone call in 2011 raised hopes. A witness named Menachem Lieberman, who was 13 at the time of the murder, called him to say he had been coached by police to pick Ranta. Lieberman said, "A police detective told me to pick the guy with the big nose." Michael Baum relayed the information to the Conviction Integrity Unit of the Brooklyn District Attorney's Office. Their investigation found two other witnesses who admitted lying. It raised questions about the police handling of the case and ultimately led the DA to ask the conviction be overturned. The lead detective in the case was Louis Scarsella. He's now retired. We reached him at his home. He claims Ranta confessed, but it was never recorded. Ranta denies he ever made a confession.
I didn't do anything wrong. I stand by my investigation, and I don't know what else to tell you.
As Ranta walked out a free man, a family friend of Rabbi Wurzburger said the rabbi's family was in shock.
Rabbi Wurzburger is not coming back. The family still feels the loss. They now are reminded again by having David Ranta released in a botch up of justice, and a botch up of prosecution.